Distribution means that each person or entity can have more than one of the elements being distributed. For example, in how many ways can 10 chocolates be distributed among 4 children? There are only 4 children, but 10 chocolates, that means one children can have more than one chocolate. The first case, all chocolates are different and any child can get any number of chocolates. The right approach would be, look at it from the chocolate's point of view. The first chocolate has 4 choices. There are 4 children. The first chocolate can go to any of the 4 children. Second chocolate can also go to any of the 4 children. Third can also go to any of the 4 children. And even the 10th chocolate can go to any of the 4 children. The answer is simply 4 into 4 into 4, 10 times 4 raised to power 10. Second example, the chocolates are similar and any child can get any number of chocolates. So here it is not about which chocolate goes to which child, it's only about which child gets how many chocolates. So there are 10 chocolates, similar, and we have to make 4 parts. So for breaking something into 4 parts, we have to make 3 cuts. Imagine if you have a rope and you want to make 4 pieces of it, you don't make 4 cuts, you make only 3 cuts. So 10 chocolates and 3 cuts, if they are all shuffled among themselves, you will always have 4 pieces. So shuffle them, 10 and 3, 13 elements, which can be shuffled in 13 factorial ways upon 10 chocolates being similar. So divide this by 10 factorial and 3 cuts being similar. So divide this by 3 factorial. The answer is 13C3. The relationship is, when n things have to be distributed among r entities, the number of ways this can be done is n plus r minus 1 c r minus 1. I avoid giving these formula. The right way is always, if you can do it conceptually, you will be able to handle any twists in the question that GMAT may offer. One more. Chocolates are similar and each child gets at least one chocolate. So now they were same thing. 10 chocolates. We have to make 3 cuts. But then first we have to make sure that everybody gets at least one chocolate. So we give one chocolate to each child. This can be done in, of course, only one way. Chocolates are similar. 4 chocolates being distributed to 4 children. That's done in only one way. So they are gone. We are left with 6 chocolate and 3 cuts. So practically 9 factorial. 6 chocolates being similar. So divide this by 6 factorial. And then 3 cuts, of course, being similar. Divide this by 3 factorial. This is 9C3. The relationship is, when n things have to be distributed among r entities and everybody must get at least one, the number of ways in which this can be done is n minus 1 c r minus 1. Once again, I would encourage that rather than remembering the formula, understand the approach. This way you will be able to handle any twists in the question. This was the concept, guys. GMAT shorts are deliberately kept brief. For an elaborate explanation, please refer the stage 1 videos. Thanks for watching.